Friday, January 22nd. There is the closing bell, guys. With the S&P's down about 12 points, we're seeing some selling in the final minutes of trade. Coming into today, we didn't expect much hitting the upper edge the other day. I got a lot to go over, so let's dive right in, break this market down, and then go over the top stocks of the day. Taking a look at the overnight trade, we trended down until about the bell, seeing a nice pop. It wasn't until about 9:45 we saw a PMI number come out, which set the tone for the day. We trended higher, and now we're seeing some selling in the final minutes of trade. When we take a look at it on a daily, we're knocking at the door to all-time highs. We're seeing a little bit more volume today, however, we held intact. When we take a look at the SPX on the week, you can see we hit the upper edge on Tuesday, we hugged it on Wednesday, we broke down today, and we failed to get above it today. So we weren't expecting much from this market today after advancing over 80 points on the short week of trade. What more can you ask for? Now we'll come back to the SPX to discuss the expected move for next week, but let's move on over to the NASDAQ and see how technology did today. Taking a look at the NASDAQ, it was down about 0.35%. When we look at it intraday, you can see some aggressive selling coming in the final minutes of trade. Now when we compare this to the Big Five, we can see that the Big Five finished down 0.08%. So it was down on the day, however, not as bad as the NASDAQ. And you can see it put a little bit of stress on the S&Ps. After having a very nice day, these index of Apple, Amazon, Google, Facebook, and Microsoft, it's slowing down, you can see, but it had a nice advance this week. Let's move on over and take a look at the small caps and see how they performed. Taking a look at the Russell, it was up over 1%, and it was our only index up on the day. So we're seeing some rotation out of technology and into some small cap names. Now, when we take a look at some of our sectors, we can see what led today. Well, the software stocks led today, up 0.64%. Now, these software stocks are inside the Russell. However, they have outgrown the $2 billion market cap. So it's not until June when we see the rebalance. But until then, they're going to have a big role in the Russell. And today, that's a big reason why we're seeing the Russell up. What's down? Well, technology's down, still near all-time highs. Energy taking it down day, down 0.5%, but you can see kind of recovered. It gapped down and trended higher as the day advanced. We look at the financials, were our worst performer in about the same boat here. So financials and energy are two sectors we want to look forward going into next week. Can they maintain where they are? Are they going to fold their hands? And if they roll over, it's going to tear this market apart. Let's take a look at our AD line and see how it broke down today. Taking a look at the AD line, we're seeing 42 advancing and 59 on the decline. So it's not a very strong AD line. What do you expect? Small caps were only index up today. We had technology flat and the S&Ps just weren't all there. When you have the financials and energy struggling, it's going to be hard to see green on your screen. So with the indexes mixed, how did the bonds break down today? Taking a look at the bonds, we're sitting right at the 169 level, up 0.35%. We've thrown on a volume profile and you can see the 169 level is the new 173 that we spent most of December hovering around that level. So it's an area where bond traders are comfortable with the bonds sitting. However, going sideways too long could see a move like we saw back in the beginning of January. We consolidated for a long time and then we just folded. So are we going to consolidate, maybe see a nice pop? Seeing that we're not falling, it could be time for the bonds to gearing up higher going into the coming weeks. Let's move on over and take a look at the volatility index. Taking a look at the VIX futures, we see they're up 1.7%. They're still moving around here. Taking a look at it on an intraday, we're seeing a nice pop going into the weekend. How did the VVIX trade? Well, it was down 0.5%, but it too is seeing a little pop going into the final minutes. Now, when we look at it, the bigger picture, the 110 line is very close. We could potentially come here Monday as a fake out and then bounce going into the week. We'll see how Monday trades, but the VVIX being down ever so slightly, it's not what you want to see if you're shorting this market. You want to see volatility accelerating higher, and we're seeing that in the futures, but the VVIX gets a broader gauge of this marketplace, and it's down to say the least. Let's move on over and take a look at the dollar index and see how our commodities did today. Seeing the dollar index up 0.1%, we're hovering right around that 90 handle, so the dollar just doesn't want to roll over just yet. How'd it do to our commodities? Well, we see crude oil down 2% at $52. So the crude oil's rolling over here a bit, which is going to hurt energy stocks. Now, when we take a look at gold, gold's down about $12 on the day, 0.68%. Gold going to be down when we see the dollar up. We look at silver, down a little bit more because it's more speculative than gold, down 1.31%. The metals are just hanging in there. So are we going to see the dollar advance higher? If so, it could put these commodities on pause. And last but not least, we have Bitcoin, and Bitcoin bouncing back very strong today, up 5% after seeing some FUD about a double spend on the network, which didn't happen. Bitcoin was down over 15% the other day, coming back very strong today. Look for a Bitcoin update over the weekend. I'm going to try to get out for you guys just where I see Bitcoin going in the coming weeks. Now, before we get into the top stocks, let's move on over to the SPX and see next week's expected move. So we go over to the SPX, we hit the trade tab, and we look 7 days out. 73 points is what the options market is pricing in for next week of trade. So this week was 87. Next week is 73 with an extra day of trade. However, there is no inauguration. So let's draw these lines in and I'll be right back. Taking a look at next week's expected move, 3914 will play our upper edge and 3768 will play our lower edge. Now, when we zoom out on this, we haven't had an outside week since Thanksgiving. So this marketplace has been efficient since November. Are we going to see an outside move happen? And if so, I would probably lean to the downside. 3768 could get tagged next week, so keep your eyes out for that level. Other than that, hitting the upper edge would put it in a new all-time high, obviously. However, just seeing how the final minutes traded, I don't know if the strength will be right there. We might slow down a bit, see some profit taking, but let's take it day by day. There you have it for the stock market breakdown. Now, there wasn't much going on today. What do you expect when we hit the upper edge on Tuesday trade? We just rested there for the most part, and the stock market held it together. We could have rolled over pretty hard, but we maintained where we were, and we were positive on the week to say the least. Now, going into next week, we have the Federal Reserve talking on Wednesday, and they could shake up this tape a bit. Other than that, let's dive right in and take a look at the top stocks of the day. So we go over to the scan tab, we hit scan, and here is our list of seven. Coming in at the number three stock of the day goes to 3D Systems Inc. Today up close to 10% with the market cap of $4.2 billion on a year to date. It's up 229%, seeing a nice pop on the seventh. What does 3D Systems do? Well, they provide three-dimensional printing solutions, including 3D printers, print materials, software, on-demand manufacturing services, and digital design tools. Now, why are we up today? Well, I can't find any specific news today, but we did have a nice pop on the 7th, and they issued preliminary quarter four sales above estimates, so it saw some nice momentum, and it got a nice pop, and the momentum's been carrying on. I know a couple stocks have been hit on Wall Street bets, so this potentially could be one of them. It did get a price target raise to $28 here on the 19th, but we're well over that level. Let's throw it on an expected move and see where we look going into next week. Taking a look at next week's upper edge, it's going to play 3782. So if the momentum wants to carry forward, look for 3780-ish to place some resistance in this stock before marching higher. Now, if we roll over, but it was a really nice day, if we do see some profit taking next week, 3114 will play our lower edge of the expected move on the week. Now, this is what the options market prices in. So we're just going off of next week's expiration, and that's where they see it going. Coming in at the number two stock of the day goes to Stitch Fix Inc. Today, Stitch Fix was up over 18% with a market cap of $10.1 billion. On a year-to-date, Stitch Fix is up 73%. It's been on a beautiful trend up since the year started. Now, what does Stitch Fix do? Well, they're a personal styling service that sends individually picked clothing and accessory items for a one-time styling fee. Now, why is it up today? It's seeing some nice volume, and it did get a price target raised to $95 by KeyBank. It's also maintained its overweight rating, so it's seeing some nice volume coming into it. When I take a look at the trade tab, it is also hard to borrow. So it also is seeing a short squeeze. Taking a look at it intraday, you can just see the nice trends and then squeezing higher into that final close. How do we look going into next week? Well, taking a look at the expected move, we can see the upper edge will play 104.13. with the lower edge at 89.71. Now, it's been on a nice trend, so if the momentum wants to keep on going, look for 104 to play some resistance. However, if we see some profit taking from today's session, now 18% is a lot, look for 89.70, call it $90 to play a lower edge of support. Coming in at the number one stock of the day goes to GameStop Corporation. Today, GameStop was up 51% with a market cap of $4.5 billion. On a year-to-date, GameStop is up 276%. Volume in the stock has come out of the blue on the 13th, and even today, we're seeing some insane volume in this stock. Now, why are we popping today? Well, it's seeing some short squeeze. However, I'm also seeing Wall Street bets have been talking about this stock. So you know how Reddit can be, and this stock is just singing today. Just taking a look at this beautiful trend higher all through the day to lunch. It got pretty crazy today in GameStop. Now, when we throw it on an expected move going into next week, if this wants to continue going higher, 77.53 will play our upper edge, which we came very close today. You can see that wick. So 77.53 would play the upper edge. However, this is a lot of gain today. It's 51%. If we see some profit taking on Monday, look for 52.50 around that area to play some nice roll of support if it wants to continue going higher. Ultimately, this move really doesn't make any sense to me, so I would just stay away from it if it was me deciding if I want to buy GameStop, but GameStop has been a wild ride. There you have it for the top stocks of the day. Did you get a chance to watch any of these stocks? If not, comment a ticker down below that you're looking at going into next week. I'd love to hear what you guys are trading. Leave a comment down below. Have any questions, comments, concerns? Let me know. I'd love to answer your questions. And if you've watched this far, I really appreciate it when you hit the thumbs up button. And if you're watching me for the first time, I do these every single day. Show some love and hit the subscribe button. Other than that, have a great weekend, guys. Take care. I'll see you on Monday. Peace!